War is causing inflation in South Sudan. The violence has not only limited agriculture, but also oil production in a country where oil is the leading foreign exchange earner. So the cost of living continues to rise.
I am very unhappy. Children, women are all suffering. Water is very expensive. Everything is expensive. As if I'm a foreigner here. But this is my country. I don't understand why things have to be this way.
I wonder why we are suffering, yet we have a country and we have resources. But today, $100 is 26,000 South Sudanese pounds. It's now heading to 30,000 pounds and everything is expensive. Everyone is talking of the dollar, but we don't even know that dollar.
Bank of South Sudan, which is responsible for the country's fiscal policy, says there is limited hard currency to meet the market demand. It says it's looking at other sources of US dollars.
The policy that we introduced last year regarding the special account is a very important policy. We wanted to use it so that the government can buy more foreign currency from the NGOs, international NGOs in particular, and the UN organizations. These funds bought from these organizations can be used also to supply to support the supply of the important commodities into the country.
Many South Sudanese people send their children to school in neighboring countries, which requires dollars for school fees. South Sudanese currency is not recognized elsewhere in the East African region, adding to the demand for hard currency.
While the prices of goods have gone up, salaries for most civil servants have not increased and often arrive late. That's a desperate situation for many because in 2013, 30,000 South Sudanese pounds could buy $10,000. Today, that money can only buy $100. Patrick Oyet, CGTN, Juba, South Sudan.